كانوا قليلا من الليل ما يهجعون.
Training of oneself, it is a struggle and a strive for every Muslim to be able to achieve this noble character of being able to be satisfied with what Allah has given them and to realize the blessings that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has bestowed upon each individual and upon us as a society and upon us as a human race. Allah subhanahu ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, the most merciful to all mankind, or the humans, or the world, the giver of mercy to specific people as well, He has not left anyone out except that He has given blessings to them. We call this ni'mah. And every single one of us here, every single individual, every old and every young, has got so many blessings that if you were to try to count them really and you thought about them, you'll not be able to finish counting them at all. But unfortunately, a lot of people today tend to count the blessings which they don't have, and that's a really wrong thing to do. We should not look at what we don't have, but rather look at what you do have. And if you do look at what you do have, you will end up being a person who thanks Allah night and day. And do you know what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about a person who thanks Allah night and day? Allah said in the Quran, وَلَئِن شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ. If you are grateful and you thanked Allah night and day, I, meaning Allah, I will give you more. I will give you more. But the condition is that you have to be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because not being grateful, meaning that you do not realize that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a merciful God. And He made us recite this verse in every ruk'ah of every salah that we pray. And your prayer cannot be accepted without reciting Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Thanks and gratitude belongs to Allah, the Lord of all, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, the most merciful, the giver of mercy, the giver of blessings, the giver of ni'mah. Thank you, O Allah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Habibuna, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the most blessed of all mankind, of all the humans, of all the races, he used to stand up in the middle of the night praying to Allah every night. One of the nights, when it was really dark and didn't have light like what we have the blessing of today, Aisha radiallahu anha extended her arm to feel if the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was next to her. But she couldn't feel his body, so she moved her arms around because she couldn't see at night. And then her hands struck the feet of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He was standing praying to Allah, his Lord. After he finished, she felt a little bit of remorse for him, thinking that he's not getting enough sleep and rest for his body. So she said, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, give your body some rest, for it is you who Allah has forgiven everything of your past, present and future sins. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam obviously never allowed himself to fall into sins, but this was the blessing of Allah. She's saying to him, at least give your body some rest. Do you know what his reply was? He said, Ya Aisha, since Allah has given me this great blessing of forgiving my sins, أَفَلَا أَكُونُ عَبْدًا شَكُورًا, should I not be a thankful servant then? A mu'min never fails to worship Allah no matter what happens. And when he's given lots of blessings, or blessings are taken away from him or her, they are still worshipping Allah and getting closer to Jannah. You give me blessings, I thank you, Ya Allah, and I'll worship you more. You take them away, I'll worship you more so that you can give me more. And so that you can test me and watch, Ya Rab, watch that I can pass your test. Which brings me to the most important part of how to increase your gratitude towards Allah. The first and most important thing for a believer to have, brothers and sisters, in their life, without it, you can't be a grateful person. You have to understand the reason and the purpose why you are created. Why are we here in the first place? Why do we have such a short life? What are all these things around us, these creations that keep reminding us about something? What do they want to tell us? They want to tell us that we have a purpose in life. And that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created us for a short time in order to test us, to examine us. This is a test for us to know, not for Allah to know, because Allah already knew, but obviously is a fair God. Allah is fair. So He needs us, We need to go through it in order so on the Day of Judgment we can stand in front of Allah and say, Ya Rab, now I know why. If you punish me, I know why. And if I enter paradise, I know why I deserve it. The purpose in life is a test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is Jannah and there is Jahannam. If you want to enter Jannah, you have to work for it. And in order to enter Jannah, you have to earn it. This is why Allah said in the Quran, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم أحسب الناس أن يتركوا أن يقولوا آمنا بالله وهم لا يفتنون ولقد فتنا الذين من قبلهم فليعلمن الله الذين صدقوا وليعلمن الكاذبين. Which means, did people assume that they will be left alone just to say, I believe, أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأن محمد رسول الله, without being tried and tested on that word? And we have tested the ones before them, and we will know who are the ones who are truthful in that word, and who are the ones who are liars when they said that word. I bear witness that there is only one God, Muhammad is his messenger, so work towards worshipping him. Work towards Jannah if you believe in that. Obey Allah and his messenger. Stay away from what he has forbidden. Thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for what he has given you if you bear witness to this, that he is your Lord. So Allah has to test us. And this is the purpose in life. You'll either earn paradise or not. For this reason, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, a true mu'min, when they receive a calamity, you know what a calamity is, right? A trial. Something that, if you don't believe in Allah, you will think, why is this happening to me? But as a believer, when you receive that calamity or that misfortune, you know that this is a test at the moment for you. Will you pass it or will you fail it? Are you going to sit there and whine over and over again and say, why me? Why not someone else? What have I done? What did I do to deserve this? Have you recalled a moment in your life when you were tested? What did you say? How did you feel? What did you think? Have you recalled a moment in your life where you thought to yourself, why is this happening to me? I'm still young. I want to party a little bit more. I want to go out with the boys, but I can't because I'm ill. Or something's happened to me. Or some of us say, I wish no illness happens in my family because then I'm going to miss out on the next weekend with the boys, maybe. Always afraid of some calamity or misfortune because we want to enjoy a little bit more of life. We want to live life to its fullest. We want to enjoy it a little bit more. There's nothing wrong in Islam with enjoying life a little bit, but obviously not in that mentality. We are not ready to be tested. We are not ready to be tried. You know what that means when you're not ready to be tested, not ready to be tried? Well, you have to revise your iman. Are you really a truthful person when you said, oh my Lord, I believe in you that you are my God, and I believe in the Quran, and I believe in Jannah, but I want to enter it without earning it. I just want to sit back, enjoy life, and enter Jannah for free. That's not possible. Can you get wealthy in this life without working for your money? No, you can't, obviously. Can you get educated and go into a stream that you want to become without going through lots of struggle and being tested and sacrificing some of your social life? We all work here. Most of us work here. And I know that the Sydney people mostly are involved in a lot of trade. A lot of them obviously go to university as well. But each and every one of us probably here is a working person. And you know how much you sacrifice from your social life, right? What, 8 hours a day maybe? Minimum, 9 hours, 13 hours of your day, you sacrifice. And we are willing to repeat that every day. Every morning, we will wake up at 6 a.m. And I hate to say if some of us forget about Fajr prayer and rather would wake up at 6. I hate to say that some of us, if the alarm didn't go off for Fajr or no one woke us up, it's no big deal. But if the alarm was missed for when we wake up for our work or no one woke us up, we go nuts. What is more important here? Well, because you see, that's a proof that a person like that maybe loves the luxury a little bit more. And when the test or calamity befalls them, I guarantee you that that type of a person, or most likely, will not be able to pass this test. They'll be the first to whine. They'll be the first to complain. They'll be the first to lose their temper. And I have seen in my life many people, when a tiny affliction befalls them, they are quick to complain about Allah, not to Allah.